just cleaned this kit, you can see from all sides, from inside, from outside, and the condition now you can see it's way better than before. It's not like new, but it is way better than before. And what I used, some people are questioning, this solvent I used, and this is of course regular gasoline. So regular gasoline, it cleaned these all the parts. So you can use whatever the solvent you are comfortable with, you can use. I am comfortable with a regular gasoline. This is readily available everywhere, and it is cheap also, low cost. So I used this one, and whatever is your choice, you can use for your work. So now this kit is ready to fix it on the car, and I will fix it, and then we'll show you the later on whatever the adjustments we are making and whatever the alignment I am making to perform this kit well with the car. So here one adjustment is, you can see this brass bolt, this brass nut or bolt or whatever, there is a spring arrangement as I show you before. And so this we will adjust it like this up to some extent where the car will behave well nicely, I mean where it will not stall and the car will stay in slow speed running very well, and also the car should start well enough. So that will be our optimum point for this nut, and then later on we will put some RTV silicone over here to lock it in position, and that lock will be temporary lock because if we will remove it, it will be removed like that. And another adjustment which I can show you is over here, this one, by using a screwdriver and 19 millimeter socket. This is now loose, you can see. I will make an adjustment with the use of a screwdriver inside, and then I will adjust it on the car. So these two adjustments I will make, and I will show you on the car. Now we are making a first attempt after repair to start this car. Maybe it will take a long crank because of course the line has no gas, and it took some air also, and it accumulated the air, and as well as the setting will not be good. I mean to say the calibration and whatever the alignment of the kit will not be good. So that's why it will take a long crank and will start. Okay, start it please. Let us see. Yeah, so it started. So as you can see, it is stalling. It is dying. So I will adjust it. I will adjust it over here. This brass, whatever, the brass bolt inside. I will tighten it, and then we will see, and we will look for the good performance and no stalling, and as well as for the good slow running. Okay, start it again. Again. Okay, remove your foot. Remove your foot from the gas. This is still not good. Okay, start it again. Okay, start it again. So we will make this internal adjustment as well. We will make this adjustment as well for the. For the good performance. Start it again. adjustment I'm showing you. This one, you will adjust this one also for the good performance. So I am grabbing my pliers. First we will loose the nut for this one. You can use anything, I mean the plier or whatever, the spanner, whatever is available with you. So this is the good point which I chewed now. Okay, remove your foot from the gas again. So here we will adjust again this brass bolt for the optimum performance. So now this seems to me a good point where the engine is still running, it is not stopping. We stopped it intentionally, but this point is good. So you will make adjustment and we will fix this nut also with a 19 millimeter, and this is the optimum adjustment for this kit. So here are the controls which I just discussed to be done. One is over here, you can see this one. This one we will adjust for the very, very much fine tuning of the kit while the car is started. We will get the optimum performance with this bolt or whatever the adjustment. And also the other one, second one is here. We will get it to the inner position, to the maximum inner position, and we will accelerate the car so that the car should accelerate with a minimum bolt out. Our maximum in. So this is what is the main gas control. We will set the car in the optimum condition so that it will not take much more gas and it will run properly. So something like that will be our optimum setting for this one. And then later on, the third one which I am going to show you is not related to the gas, but it is related to the engine carburetor, which is over here. You can see this screw, this one over here. This one is adjusting actually the idle speed for this carburetor. So we will set the idle speed in such a way that the car should not stall or should not stop while it is started. I mean to say that the car should stay start. We will set the idle position in such position, idle throttle, I mean to say, this is setting this throttle cable in the position that the car will stay start. So something like that. Now I am going to show you how I optimized this setting. So the setting you can optimize with your experience and with a little bit hit and trial method. You can make it very, very much nice setting for your car. For this one I did. Now I am just going to show you. I am out of the car. Now you can see, and there is no control touched. My son is sitting actually, but he is not touching to any control. Don't touch any control. So we are going to start the car. I am going to start this one from the ignition, you can see. So just ignition I will give and I will start the car from the outside. So let us see if your car is doing like this, then you can say it is optimized. So like this, and so it is started like a petrol car is starting, and it is staying start. You can see it is not dying. So this is the optimum setting for this one, and now it is of course on gas. You can see the gas lights, you can see, and here also you can see the dashboard. So this one was. Now I'm going to show you how to set the idle. You will set in the way by this screw. You will set in the way that it should just idle. It should not be very, very much high speed. I mean to say, the engine should not run very high and should not run very slow, so that it will not come to stop in certain condition while on the road. You are inside the rushy condition and then the car is stopping, so that's something very bad. So now, as you saw, the condition is optimum. Now I'm going to stop it again and will start it in the front of you once again. There is nobody in the car and I'm starting from the outside. So the starting is like a gasoline car is starting, something like that. That is your optimum starting condition for this car. So hope you people understood what I did with the setting and you people will be able to do it with your cars also. So if you like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe my channel, and also stay tuned for the future videos. Thank you for watching.